Afternoon, Russell here. What we got going on today is I've got to replace the blower motor and the fan controller on this 2001 Corvette. Kind of a common problem in modern vehicles. We've seen this go bad in Mini Coopers, BMWs, Chevrolets, you name it. Basically any car now that has what we call an automatic heat and air system, you know, where you can set the temperature and say auto, and the fan speeds very automatically. We have this problem with, and it's just a time thing. The computer circuits go bad. I'm going to move the camera and show you the symptoms of a bad fan controller and or a bad fan, I'll show the actual replacement. It's not too bad on this Corvette here. There's some other vehicles where it's very difficult. So I'm gonna move the camera right now. So the primary symptom to a bad fan controller is, well, you don't get your fan motor going. So I'm gonna...
Then because they offer.
Power the car up, right? And right now the temperature's set at 67. I know you guys can't see this, but and then I hit the auto button, and I get nothing, no fan. Try and bypass and go into manual mode, run the fan to full speed, and I got nothing, absolutely nothing. So we've got, basically the fan's not working. And in most of these vehicles with the automated systems, there's no fuse for the fan motor. It's actually circuit controlled by the controller, and it is relayed on the entire system. So if you've got your display working but no fan, then more than likely it's the fan controller and or the motor. In the case of this Corvette, because of the positioning of it, and it's not an expensive part, you just do both. You're already there, go ahead and do both. I'm going to move the camera again and try and show you exactly where in this Corvette this fan motor, the blower motor, and the fan controller is. Now I've already removed some of the paneling to gain some access here. But essentially, and let's see, let me get a flashlight. On these C5 Corvettes, right there, you can see the fan motor, and the controller is mounted right. Now let's mount it up in there. So essentially I'm gonna have to lay on my back and tear all this out and put the new stuff in. So I'm gonna get at it here real quick. I'll put the camera back on the mount. And there's just no real good way to do this. It just kind of sucks. Thank you. Okay.
This is funny. All right. The culprit has been found. I still don't know for sure. We'll find out here shortly. If we have a bad fan or a bad controller. But let's start with the history of this car. 2001 Corvette, less than 22,000 miles, one owner. So obviously, this vehicle sat a lot. Lo and behold, shoved in the fan motor. You see it? It's a dead mouse. How long he's been stuck in there, I have no idea. But I would bet you that him being in there unbalanced this thing and ate the motor up. Probably ate up the controller as well. So we're going to replace both of them and fingers crossed it fixes it. But yeah, you own a car and don't drive it a lot, put some mothballs in the HVAC system or something to keep these guys out. God.
So along with the mouse, we found up in the cavity with the fan motor, essentially a rat's nest, a mouse nest. Looks like it's made from rock wool or blanket, like maybe they had stored the car with a blanket on top of it or something, which I've seen that done. And I've seen mice and rats chew up those kind of woolly padded blankets to make nests, so I gotta finish cleaning this out.
Fucking engineers. All right, after much consternation and fighting with it, because of access, I finally got this out. This is the old fan control module. It's an integrated circuit type system. And it actually mounts, once I have it all together, I'll put the camera up and show you, kind of try and show you everything where everything's at. But this mounts up against the forward part of the firewall prior to the motor. And getting to these two screws here proved to be moderately difficult. I actually disconnected one of the control modules, other control modules in the floorboard to get access, but I'll show all that once it's all reinstalled. So I'm just gonna pause the video now, put it all back in, and then show you all the final installation.
All right. You see that little pigtail coming out right there? And there's the module. I'm shining the flashlight on it right now. That's the little booger we had to replace. So honestly, to get it out, you have to remove the fan blower motor. So if you're already removing the blower motor to get to the module, just go ahead and replace the blower motor. The mouse nest was all up in there. We had to clean all that out up in there. So we'll get the motor in and we'll get this thing done. All right. Fan motor's installed, wired up, plugged in.
We'll test it here real quick. So we'll set the temp. I got temp set at 70 auto. I'm gonna run the fan motor up, you can hear it.
Well, I'd say that's all there is to it. A little bit more difficult than I expected, but really hard to get some of those back screws. Once I was able to get to them, though, they came out just fine. Module comes in and out quickly. The fan motor as well. It's just like any other fan motor. At least on these vehicles, you can actually get to it. But very surprising to find the mouse nest inside the blower motor. And all up into the ductwork. It took quite a bit to clean that out. But anyway, successful job. We'll get this thing buttoned back up and put back out on the line. fun job. Anyway, not a difficult job to do. Not the easiest one in the world either. Laying on your back, working with some small screws. And funny enough, I've had this socket in my toolbox for years. It's a 5.5 millimeter socket. Never used it. Never had a need for it. Well,
go and figure, the three screws that hold the motor in and the three screws that hold the controller in are 5.5 millimeters. So I actually had a tool I got to use for the first time ever in my life. But anyway, we got it out, we got it in. Getting to the back two screws on the module, pretty difficult. I actually had to disconnect the one of the other control modules to kind of get access, but and move it out of the way. And if you're ever doing one on a Corvette and you get down in there, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. There's a couple more modules under there. So disconnect those modules and pull them out of the way, and then you can get back up in there to the two screws after the motor's out, and then you can get the control module out. Installation's reverse of the removal, goes back together nice, and as you can see and hear from the previous portion of this video, fan motor's running great. So we'll get this button back up, back out on the line. Once again, if you like this content, go ahead and hit the bell icon, hit like, hit subscribe, do the thing that you guys do. Channel's growing. I'm enjoying it. I enjoy shooting these videos. If you have any ideas or comments on future videos, whether it's auto related, anything, just shoot me a message. I'll see what I can do. I got some good stuff, content coming up soon. And as always, more to follow.